Hi, Kevin here. Hey, I want to talk to you guys a little bit about the Apple TV and some of the uses. I've been playing around with this for a little bit. Inman Schools USD 448 has a site out there called I Teach with iPads, and I spend a lot of time on there talking to teachers who've been involved in a one-to-one implementation of iPads 9 through 12, but the district is using a lot of iPads and therefore solving a lot of problems as they go along. And one of the things that they've been doing is using the Apple TV for screen sharing in the classroom. For the classroom computer. So if you've ever been frustrated by having to hold the dongle in between your fingers to keep it from falling out because you're trying to share to the screen so kids can see the screen, this can be a frustrating issue. So talked to a friend of mine on a plane coming back from O'Hare the other night and who shared some ideas with me on how we might use this. So I went out and got the Apple TV and I hooked it all up. And so I'm going to show you some of the things that I'm learning, that I've learned today so far. First of all, here's the Apple TV. And it's hooked up with an HDMI cable. The cable goes going back here and plugging in to the back side of this particular TV. Now, if you're presenting with a projector and you don't have an HDMI port on that thing, you'll do what I've done. I've ordered an adapter so that if I'm stuck with just VGA only, I can send HDMI through VGA. I know I'll lose some resolution. It won't be quite as pretty, but it will be functional on the road. So what I'm going to get, and what I've got ordered right now, is an AB switch, so I can go from one VGA source to another. So my laptop will be going into that switch, and the Apple TV will be going into that switch. So if I push A, it's the laptop; B, it's the iPad via the Apple TV. And now I'm walking around without wires. So I'm going to show you kind of how this looks and how this works. But let's go all the way back to the first generation iPad 1, if I want to share. Screen sharing, even this way, isn't native, but if you're on this network and you double-click here, you're going to come all the way over and you're going to see a new button pop up with the release of 5.1. So if you click that guy, it's going to pop up and let you choose, Kevin's Apple TV. So I'm going to click that. Okay, and now this particular iPad is on that network, but I can't just plain screen share. Not natively like I can on the iPad 2, and that's a little frustrating, but you can share some things. So I'm going to jump off of here. And just put a movie on. Now, of course, a movie will play because you could always screen share a movie back then. Let me go back here and do that again. Let's do this with YouTube. We'll do it with YouTube.
I guess I'll take you to this real quick and show you. You know, I talk about this all the time. Most kids in their lifetime will get a guitar, but most of them won't learn.
Okay, so that's YouTube, right? So YouTube is sharing just fine. Your movies will share. Your music will share. I love that audio goes through the wires, too, or through the not wires, too. Now think about the workarounds that you might do. Of course, you're going to be able to use, because we could always screen share, even on the one, Keynote. So if you're just running a standard presentation through Keynote, you should be fine. The interesting thing is once the Apple TV is live in an environment and not password protected, and it's up to you if you want to give the password out, but any participant in the room can jump on and use it. So if you're doing an iPad workshop and you want somebody to show their screen, you can just have them take over. The next device, you know, will take over. So let's try this now with the Motorola Zoom. And with the Zoom, I'm going to go out and show you the app that my friend Pete Lundgren showed me today for this. Actually, a couple of friends helped me out with all of this. I'm natural with all of this stuff here. So let's go back a couple, though, and I'll show you the app on the Android side is called, O Media Share, and it's an O exclamation point Media Share is what we found to work on the Zoom. There's another one and some other ones that work okay on a phone to share, but the way it shares media, let's go to photos. You can share your photos. You can share your videos. I've only got one video on here, so I'll just do the one that I have. Click the movie, click this, it's going to say my phone or to Apple, Kevin's Apple TV. I'm going to click that, and it will launch then that movie, kind of buffers and starts. Now, in my opinion, the things you can do on the iPad 1 and on the Motorola Zoom and is about the same thing. I mean, you can share applications that were made to share, like video or audio. Music sounds great. It depends on, of course, what you're connected to over here. So let's go down to the iPad 2. on the iPad too, I'll double click the belly button. It pops up the little menu of apps that are running. Slide all the way over and you'll see a screen share thing. Click that, and on this one it says Apple TV and gives you this option of mirroring. You don't get the option of mirroring back on the iPad 1. Okay? Still frustrated about that. I want that to work. So click this guy, and up there on the screen you'll see that you're just screen sharing like you do with a dongle, and apps run, everything runs. It's slick. I gotta tell you, testing it out in this room and walking around this room, and I can walk a good ways from the TV and from the Apple TV source all the way over to the corners of the room. And it tells me that in a big workshop environment, even in a keynote environment, this is pretty bulletproof. I would probably password protect the Apple TV in case anyone in the audience decided they wanted to take over my screen mid-presentation, you know, but that's no big deal. So the way I'm thinking of this is part of my portable road kit when I'm doing keynotes and stuff. I'm going to plug the Apple TV back into the projector, wherever the projector might be. I'm going to take my VGA, split that out of my AB switch, wherever you know I am, they're going to hand me a VGA to plug into the computer. I'm just going to split that, run one to the laptop and one to the Apple TV, and be trying that immediately as I'm doing demos with the iPad. I'm going to connect it in some different ways. I'm going to use my Roland Mobile Cube and run sound through this. Now this little guy here, Roland Mobile Cube, I'll show you real quick, does a great job with audio. It's very portable, fits in a suitcase. I think I paid $165 for it. It'll run on 6 AA batteries if you're really kind of up against it and have no place to plug in. So I can run multiple sources into it. So what I do is I use splitters, and I plug splitters into splitters into splitters to end up getting lots and lots and lots of cables into one 1/8-inch stereo plug. And that way I can plug everyone's device in to one device and get a lot of utility out of that device. I also plug in the laptop to get good sound too. So that's what will be going on there in my little kit. Let me just throw one more thing at you. My friend Charlie Mahoney, he's working in a music store in Los Angeles, turned me on to this Jengus equipment. And this Jengus equipment, again, if you're a road warrior like me, you never know what sound you're going to have. You're at the mercy of whatever system, and you need a little bit of control. All right, this little system here is a digital wireless system, rechargeable through USB, and you plug that in. It has a splitter, so it charges both at the same time. One unit is sending, one unit is receiving. Plug one into the amplifier, one into your earpiece, and you get this really good earpiece that comes with this with a microphone that you can walk around and be powered and have a good mic for about 6 hours. So at lunchtime, plug it back in and recharge it, but you don't have batteries to worry about. This little thing fits in a box this big and fits in your suitcase. So this is one of my favorite little finds lately that give me that sort of edge out there on the road. Now, when you're in a school and you don't know if you can get on the network, if you can't get the Apple TV on a network that you can share with your devices, you're stuck. So again, if you're carrying around your cellular wireless, you can get on your own network. And my big experiment is going to be, if I have no internet connectivity with bad cellular in a region, can I still just use this as an AP to share the devices back and forth? I need to know that's going to work. So that's my experiment for tomorrow, is just to make sure that I'm bulletproof if this is charged, whether or not I have internet. You never know what your situation is going to be. So, one more thing I wanted to show you on the iPod Touch. So on the iPhone, I'll do that too. Here's the iPod Touch. The iPod Touch, and I'll slide over here. I think we have a movie queued up here. We do. And so on the iPod Touch, it looks like this. And over here, you've got a screen sharing thing. You click that, choose Kevin's Apple TV, hit play.
10 million, and its capital and largest city is Prague. Prague is famed for its historical architecture and is one of the most popular tourists.
So that's the iPod Touch, and one more, last device. So far, we've done the iPad 1. We've done Motorola Zoom, we've done the iPad 2, we've done the iPod Touch, and now going to the iPhone. So I'm going to the iPhone and see what I can find here real quick. Let's start slideshow of just pictures. Of course it does video, and it does YouTube, you know, all that stuff there, media. Jump back into pictures. Darn it, sorry. Now, click the screen sharing thing, choose Kevin's Apple TV. The next device seems to kick the last device off, so you don't have to worry about that, unless you've not given a password to the thing and you've got people taking over, usurping your network. But as I scroll through, You can see there's a little bit of a delay. Just for grins and giggles, we'll try a video here. Video. Let's go to here. I wish you could screen share the phone too, natively. And if someone figures that out, please tell me how you did it, because I'd like to see that. Where are my videos? Video. Where are you? I know what you're thinking. You're judging me. You're saying he doesn't keep his apps organized. Yeah. Stop it. Okay. I'm good at other things. Organization's not it. Let's see here. I looked at it twice already. Let's try. No. I got Keynote on here. So hypothetically, I could run presentations from here. Haven't tried it yet, but, you know. Try iTunes. Let's just see if we can do a song. No, I don't want to load the... There we go. Music. Sorry. A little late in the day. Let's do this one. There it is. So audio, of course. Anyway, it's way longer than it needed to be, but you get the gist. I wanted to share some of the stuff we were learning today. I want to thank Ginger Lumen. I want to thank Pete Lundgren. I want to thank, who else I had? Connor Jansen helped me out. Who's my other guy that helped me out today? Who else helped me out over there today? Well, I'll try to properly thank everybody tomorrow, but we all kind of came in here and played around until we kind of figured out the code. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.